always believe that in many ways music is the sort of emotional soul of the film. My job is an empathetic job. It's to find the group of notes that expresses the emotion that's on the screen.
You know what, let's put the violin in with the viola. So Tom, you'll be playing an E like Andy's playing from bar one.
Still Alice is a film about Alzheimer's. It stars Julianne Moore and Alec Baldwin and Kristen Stewart. It's about how a family deals with their mother's illness and how those relationships fall apart and come together. Alzheimer's is something that's been quite close to me. Two of my good friends have had parents who've died from Alzheimer-related things, and when I saw the trailer and the amazing performances, I was immediately completely drawn to the project. So I get the film and you do a spotting session with the directors and you sit and you talk about the film, where the music should be, what kind of music it should be, and you have a detailed conversation about the scenes, the narrative, and you haven't made all these decisions. But eventually you find yourself just sat in front of the keyboard at your computer with the film in front of you, and you have to start writing, you have to make up a tune, and that's always the most terrifying moment for me.
What do you think?
That was a
really nice one. I thought it was a great take. I wouldn't mind doing one more, see if we get a bit, get something even more magical.
Oh, hi.
Wash and Richard are very generous directors.
And here's the live room.
They have this really amazing ability to be very clear and direct about artistically where they want to go with the film, but at the same time, to be completely open. They really allowed me the space to be creative and to bring what I wanted to bring to the film, and it's artistically very satisfying.
So I added some extra motion into that, and it took to that really well. And so we're gonna need to do that on 2 and 12 as well at the end.
All right, nice, very cool.
I wanted to work with string trio because it's a difficult discipline, and historically a lot of composers didn't write for trio. Typically you'll have a bass line, you'll have a melody line, and then you'll fill the harmony in between with two other notes. But with string trio, you don't have that option. You've got to have all three players playing three different notes all at a time. Or if you don't, then you're missing one of the notes out from the chord. And that idea fascinated me in relation to dementia and bits of memory disappearing. When you're working with a small group of musicians like this, the individual characteristics of the musicians come out a lot more, and there's a lot of solos in this music, and so I picked the musicians I wanted very carefully. They're extremely sought after musicians, some of the greatest in London. I like to leave a certain amount of it open to interpretation. I want them to bring their artistry, in the same way that directors, and certainly Wash and Richard, wanted me to bring my artistry. I really hope that comes across in the score, but they're fundamental to the process. The music that played when she was having an episode, that was tricky. It used these quite unusual violin techniques where you kind of bow across the string a lot, but we didn't want it. It couldn't sound scary. It needed to sound maybe a little disturbing or a little unusual.
Yeah. Well, like the hardest couple of days I've had in a long time.
Like, a lot of that was about how the musicians performed it.
Yeah, it'd be a bit nasty, maybe.
And I worked at length with them to get that right, and with Wash and Richard to make sure that what we were doing was depicting that emotion through music in an appropriate way.
Yeah, because otherwise we'd have to have an F in it, and that'd be horrible.
it's not often that you're given a project where people want a very classical approach to the score, and that's very fun. String trio and piano and the style of music that we wrote, and the instruments being very upfront and very characterful, and the depth of emotion that was required in the music. These are all great challenges and difficult challenges. And so I guess for me that's artistically very satisfying, and I guess I just hope I've done a really great job of it.